It's been some time since I last saw you, and in those days, you were building Alexa from the ground up, really. Yeah. Let's start with Nova 2. This is the second generation of Amazon and AWS's frontier model, and it's a year since the first iteration came out. This is a fancy question, but in the sort of Amazon model taxonomy, you put a lot of emphasis on reasoning. Mm-hmm. What is different with Nova 2 in that regard?
Yeah, Nova 2, state-of-the-art frontier models, we introduced four of them today. A year back, we announced Nova, first generation of the models. Incredible adoption that we see with our customers. It's not been that we have only done Nova 1, but along the way, we introduced many new models like Nova Sonic, Nova Premier. But today, we announced our Nova 2 generation, which has four models. Each are very multimodal reasoning-based models, which means they process not just text as input, but many other modalities. They're great for perception tasks, for everyday workflows, cost-effective reasoning-style model where you can control the extent of the reasoning. You also have an upgrade to Nova Sonic and a first-of-its-kind model called Nova Omni, which not only just generates text, but also generates image output.
The simple question a lot of people have is, why did you need to have four variants and four different degrees of model performance in one release?
Yeah, so we always find customers want different selection, different operating points. But let me get to the main thing here, which
please
will put it in context. If you think about it, the perennial challenge we have in the industry, new model comes out, benchmarks look great. Customers try it in production, both internal and external customers that we have. And we find the consistent feedback, it doesn't work in our environment as we would think, or in our production setting. So that's where the reality sinks in. There is a simple reason for that, because these frontier models, as great they are, they do not know your domain, your proprietary workflows, which sit behind your walls. So we ask the question, how can we build something that knows your systems, your data? And for that, the real answer was that everyone is seeking a frontier model that's expert in your domain. Now, you have a few choices right now. All of them are suboptimal. You can start fine-tuning on the edges of frontier model. You can take an open weights model
Suboptimal, why?
I'll get into that. So you can fine-tune only on the edges, for instance, because you have these adapter-based model training, which doesn't really give you the full expertise, because these models are already fully built. So
right,
you can't steer them through your domain. And when you try to steer it to your domain, it forgets a lot of its general properties that were remarkable. So then you're left with this ultimate choice, which is, do I build my own from scratch? But that's prohibitively expensive. So that's why we brought Nova Forge, because now you have a way of building your own frontier model, starting with every stage of the model development, from pre-training to mid-training and post-training, with one unique thing, which is you can now infuse your data and premix with Amazon curated.
So let me jump in here. I'm not going to be to pretend to be smarter than I am. You can have a foundation model with tens of billions, hundreds of billions of parameters. But the issue that you're outlining is that if it has no relevance to you in its data set, it has a limited utility.
Yes.
So let's go to Nova Forge. This is the ability to build a model using data sets from within your own company.
Yes.
Simple layman's interpretation.
Right.
Just go a bit further on what you're trying to solve for here. And actually, if it's as good as you say, the commercial importance of it.
Yeah, because the general intelligence model are not, it's not like intelligence is a monolith process, right? So the intelligence to be really useful in your setting, you need to plug in your data, your knowledge, your system workflows. And that starts with the earliest stages of the training. That's how we grow up. A lot of our foundational capabilities, we are the most efficient if we have learned the domain as early as possible. That's what we are trying to do with Nova Forge. You have every multiple checkpoints available for you to make Nova your own, which we actually call a novella, right? And you can name it whatever you want. But this is becomes your model, which knows your environment, that's optimized as a variant that you can build your applications and agents for. And the beauty is that it preserves the foundational properties, because the core data that gives that frontier intelligence is also mixed with your proprietary domain knowledge.
I always am a bit hesitant to give these kind of behind the scenes moments, but before we started this live conversation, we were debating, is Amazon or AWS a full stack AI company? The debate around it is AWS has always been number one, cloud computing in terms of scale for both compute capacity, storage, and what's available, right? Is it the number one AI company is now the question. And what unites those two debates is cost and efficiency.
Yes.
What is different with the Nova 2 generation and with Nova Forge from that perspective?
Absolutely. First, AWS, I'm glad people think of it as infrastructure because that's where everything starts. But to us, it's always been a full stack company where you have the infrastructure layer, the model and AI as a service at the middle layer, and at the top layer, you have multiple applications that are serving our customers. So it's always been a full stack. With Nova, as you said, we are making really democratizing the AI for everyone, where everyone can have their frontier model that knows their domain. And with that, the beauty is that you can the cost goes down for building your applications on top of this model that's your variant, because you can start with a model that can actually be distilled from a large teacher model or a smaller model that can be still very performant compared to other large giant models. So that also gives you a huge cost lever. And this is why Forge is great, because it's making AI more affordable as well for everyone.
What are the benchmarks by which you hold yourselves to account on that? I think you've discussed with my colleague Matt Day about Nova 1 generation, where it ranked in the benchmarks. The real test is in real world deployment. But is it as simple as saying cost per token, latency, multimodal latency? How do you judge your efforts?
Yeah, first of all, public benchmarks are a good indicator, but they are not sufficient. The real indicator is performance in your real world environments. And that comes down to accuracy, cost, latency. And that's why we refer to this as price performance. Nova models are industry leading in price performance because we have optimized for all three together. And that's incredibly hard. And with Forge now, we are giving you those knobs to optimize for your price performance deals, because your applications may have a different scaling requirement, different kind of use cases. And now you have the same knobs that our internal teams have. And that's why I love Forge.
Rohit, internally, is AGI a goal and a remit that you've been given by this company to achieve?
Yeah, first of all, I wish AGI was thought about as a practical thing, not a sensationalizing element. To me, we are really focused on building this generally intelligent model that can be forged into these different specialists that do useful things in your environment. And starting with the digital environment is great. Things will happen in the physical environment as well. This is why we have giant robotics efforts as well, internally and externally. You see a lot of people working in that area. So I'm a very optimist about practical AGI that will help everyone in humanity.
Very quick fact check. Nova Forge, I've seen a number of $100,000 per year. What does that represent? It's a per desk, it's a per training exercise. Explain the business model of it.
Yeah, it's by your company's account. I mean, we can. The key is that I would focus on not that amount, because you have to think about what you're getting for it. You're getting the deepest access possible in what I think of as open training paradigm, where you're also getting access to frontier scale data mixing that makes these properties of the model be not just general purpose, but also more specialized in your domain. So the value is incredible. And then I think you will see that this kind of a value, that amount is actually minuscule in the context of things.
When we first met, you were building Alexa, early generations of Echo Dot. As you know, have an Echo device in most rooms in my house, and I have been able to use Alexa Plus. But my interactions with Alexa, the latest generation, are not what my interactions are with various other tools from OpenAI, Anthropic, Google, particularly in voice. You know, I think about how I use ChatGPT voice. But there is improvement. Can you, because it's still within the portfolio for you, what comes next with Alexa, and how are you going to take the work you've done with Nova to make improvements, because Alexa is built on Nova, among other models?
So Alexa Plus, I'm super excited about. If you haven't used it, I urge you to use it a lot now. It's a remarkable upgrade over the Alexa of the one that you've been using for a while. It's completely re-architected from the ground up. But the customer reception has been great. We are seeing, personally in my usage, it's a much more useful and very natural AI. And what all it can do is still, I haven't seen something that can do everything Alexa Plus can do.